Good evening, everyone. We're just starting live here. This is Dr. Renata von Kohl speaking. And we're going to have today a super special person here, Dr. Mikkel H.G. Hoff. That is the ANF creator, inventor. And he will be talking to us about breast awareness and breast health. So I really hope you guys can be with us all the interview. That it's loads of content he will be sharing. I am a true experience, like I have experienced some issues with my breast, and he has helped me big time with ANF therapy. And so I'm very happy to be able to share with you guys. This month is the pink month, and the October pink, and we have to be raising the awareness. More and more cases of cancer is coming between women, and we have to pay attention, you know, so many things we can do in to our health to be supporting our systems and avoiding the cysts that with time can turn into cancer. So there is many connections, many things. So good to see you all here to our breast, and I want him to tell you about that. So now I'm just gonna send a request. So I think it's just coming, connecting.
Yay, all right. Hello. Nice to see you.
Hello. How are you?
How are you doing? You look good. Amazing.
Thank you so much for being here.
My pleasure. Always.
I know you had a busy day, but you know, in the October month where we all raise the awareness for the breast cancer and breast health, I think that's how we should call. I'm sure you have loads. A lot to talk about, but we're gonna just start introducing yourself, please.
Okay, I'm Dr. Mikkel. I'm the inventor and founder of ANF Therapy and ANF Academy, also medical bachelor. I'm also a PhD in the biochemistry function of the human body, and to top that, also an educated psychologist. So it's a little bit about myself. So I know a little bit and focused my whole life on details and the pre-process of different diseases, more or less all of them. So it's a little bit of introduction.
Yes, I call you one of my angels on earth. I'm so thankful for finding out ANF and for everything you've done for me, and also for my breast, if you remember that. And after all, I was even able to breastfeed my baby, which was a miracle, and I thank that to you. So, and to in name of all my patients, I treat a lot of patients post-cancer, and I had mastectomy and everything, and how ANF can do so much even after going to the whole procedures and everything. But today I would like to talk a little bit more of awareness, you know, how we can, there is so many systems with ANF, the integration of the systems, and the breast end up being a secondary thing, as I learned from you. So I'd like you to explain a little bit further, and like how the breast is related to what we talk about, inflammation, and you know, what we
do. No, the breast is, first of all, I want to say like this, that the female body is totally different compared to the male body. Of course, that you know, but when you read about medicine, it's very general when you talk female and male. But the female body is, I would like to say, 5 to 10,000 times more different than the male body, and especially made and to reproduction. That means also that the female body's immune response, narrow oscillation system, the blood system, everything is different from us men. And if you go to the emotional system, it's between 3 to 5,000 times stronger than the man. And all this influence on your breasts, on your ovarian, on your uterus, and everything that the female body works around. So when we talk about awareness of the breast, that actually is part of the lymphatic system. And this is also why so many women get problem with the breast, is the knowledge about the lymphatic system function and what it actually is doing and how the breast is connected to this is actually the reason so many women get breast cancer. And The key factor to this is actually the liver, because the liver is the main motor together with the spleen of the lymphatic system. And if this liver doesn't work properly and these toxins comes out in our bloodstream, and that also means lymphatic system, it will also affect your mama glands, that is part of the lymphatic system, and when you start to produce milk. And all of these kind of toxins, when they come into that system, is what I can see is actually an all female I examined during all these years that have cysts in the breast or amenorrheosis, ovary, uterus, or whatever, is actually the common thing is a liver that is not good enough.
Yes, I even put, I made a bit of a suspense to everyone. I was like, there is an organ, very important organ, who is connected to the breast, that, in you know, we tend to not pay attention and not have idea how toxins into our liver, which of course, as we know in ANF, you know, our liver may most of the time get toxic due to the lymphatic not being able to process and to get rid of all the toxins, and that is, it starts to become toxic into the glands and expanding. So I always explain to the patients, because sometimes they're like, how come my liver, and we're treating the liver, it ends up easing off the breast and the whole symptoms of PCOS and the period cramps that we're on, as you said, we're so complex, so many hormones that can, you know, mess up into our bodies. So, and so, I mean, with ANF, I'll just share a little bit of my story, because I remember once we were, I think, level 6 of the course, and Irina was showing us the, you know, how to examine it. And she's like, wow, you have huge cysts. So my mom had, she had her, all her glands removed at the age of 44, I think. And she actually needs to put a implant because she was having some bleeding. And so I put in my mind, that was the thing. I said, when I'm 40, after I have kids, I will remove all my glands and I'll put an implant. And I had no idea that these cysts and these things that I had since teenager, I had these cysts since teenager time, could go like that. So, you know, with ANF, we did few protocols on the breast and supporting the liver. And my breast was really, really completely normal. I never feel like without cysts before. So to me, it was strange to not feel that. So I would really recommend, I mean, it's hard for women to understand that, you know, it's not normal to have cysts. A lot of doctors will say, oh, it's normal to have cysts, let's remove, you know, and so many patients I had, they had removed and then it comes back and then remove and then it comes back all the cysts. So we have to understand this whole holistic thing on how, you know, taking care of our lymphatic system, our liver, you know, balance our hormones, the estrogen when it spikes, and it's so many things that we know we spike estrogen, like stress, alcohol, sugar, and so many things. So when we can balance that and get into optimal level of health, this actually disappears, this actually goes. So if you can give us some, you know, tips, well, of course, with ANF treatment, but together with ANF treatment, we always recommend, you know, sugar and how sugar influences the inflammation.
I want to do like this just to give your people that follow you a little bit idea what we're doing here and what you are today treating and why ANF is so successful when it comes to these areas, and also what is actually going on physically in the human body that could create like breast cancer, or I would also like say ovarian and uterus cancer, because it's very well connected. And first of all, I want to talk a little bit about emotional traumas, because emotional trauma is actually the trigger to everything when it comes to diseases and stuff like this. And when we talk about this, we know also that the female emotional system, because everything that has to do with the female body is done for reproduction, actually develop a baby by the embryonic stem cells that you have in the sac and so on. All of this is extremely sensitive for emotional stress. And why is this? Because every time you feel anxiety, worriness, you have this bad stomach feeling, unexplained fatigue, small memory losses, wake up more tired than when you are going to sleep and stuff like this, is a typical sign that you as a female should be really considered to get checked clinically. I mean, all of this was called chronic invisible inflammations. that is the pre-process of everything. You can't see an MRI, you can't see it on a CT scan. And this is why I was taught by some of the best at that time, 25, 30 years ago, that everything, you can find everything in the human body with this, if you know what to feel for. And this is also what we teach. And just to come into what you should be thinking as a woman, and most people that develop cyst or breast cancer, whatever, is after delivery. And why is this? And also when we talk about fibromyalgia and anything and stuff like this, now we focus on the breast. And this is because that no emotional trauma is bigger than pregnancy. You have this all these 9 months where your body is actually taking all the resources the mother have to create a baby. And yes, it's beautiful that we can actually wake up and one day deliver a baby and take it to our chest. But if you just use 10 seconds to think about how can the female body know how to create a baby? Where the heart should be, where the kidney should be, what kind of cells do we take and hormone can the nurses infuse with to create the different organs? If you just use a little bit of this time, you also understand that that means that this little baby or stuff need to take these resources from the female body. And that means the mother's immune response at this time is very low compared to non-pregnant. Then comes the emotional system that puts in the last month before delivery, you start to get afraid of cracking up, you start to get afraid of that, how should I deliver the baby, you start to get afraid of the pain, and all this kind of stuff. And these create even more problems and more emotional trauma, bigger than you think. And after you delivered and everything gone well, or maybe not well, you start to get worried about the breastfeeding, then you cannot sleep. And the next 15 years, you are in an emotional trauma roller coaster. What happened here is the body will now release extremely high of more cortisol, stress hormone. This stress hormone is also to protect us. But when it continues, because when you are pregnant and when you deliver, what happens is that nobody tells you, is you create massive high amount of invisible inflammations. Mm-hmm. And because of after delivery, you come home from the hospital, the stress continues all the time because it's a new life, it's a new situation. And nobody told us how to be mom and dad. We just throw into this. We go to medic school or engineer school or whatever, but to be mom and dad, nobody knows anything. And that is probably the most important job of everything. That stresses us emotionally extremely much. And as a mother, even more. That means now, when the high cortisol releases, you start to develop what's called cortisol poisoning. And that means a lot of your systems now is actually going on spare power, low power. And you can see it on all these women, they start to develop cellulites, they start to lose, their asses is not as nice as before, the breast, the skin, and everything. And this is
the
typical. Exactly. Some women here, and this affects your lymphatic system massively. And that means now also your blood start to high quality, your liver not working properly anymore because you start to attract the liver to toxic lipids. It cannot detox your system from pharmaceuticals or even worse, artificial supplements and stuff like this. And that means the blood that now starts to circulate is not as clean as high quality anymore. Mm-hmm. That means your lymphatic system that is connected to your breast, during 10, it takes 10 to 20 years to develop any type of cancer. Mm-hmm. Or cyst and stuff like this, the first stage. And this is because of the toxins now start to go in your lymphatic system. And then they start to infect your lymphatic nodes. It starts to leak out in your mama glands and you start to get cysts. And this can start very early in the female life. And maybe even worse, they start to take what's called birth control pills and stuff like this.
Yeah, I'll tell you, in my case, I remember myself at 16 years old complaining of breast pain and, you know, putting the pills at 16 years old to control the cysts on the breast. I mean, mm-hmm. Now understanding all these symptoms, you can understand, and I hope we bring this awareness to women here to understand that there is so many other things we can do. And thank you for explaining all that, so you know women can understand how connected and how they can help themselves.
So when we come to this, I can talk for hours about this with all the glass and different senses. I'll probably not give all of you so much, but I want you really to understand the importance of this. And when it comes to your female body and your emotions, connections. But when we come back to what can you do in your daily life to prevent this from happening? Number one, your lymphatic system have 15 liters of liquid. And these 15 liters need to be renewed every single night with 3 liters new lymphatic system to be able to produce high quality of your blood. So this means that every night and every day before you go to sleep, the last time you go and urinate, should the urine be totally clear so you know your body's hydrated. Number two, stay away from a therapist that is very close to you that know how to examine the lymphatic system. So two things that is important. Drink water, minimum 3 liters a day, but not bulking. Make sure the last urination before you go to bed, your urine is totally clear. Number two, stay away from sugar. And when it comes to fruits, especially banana and grapes, because this is actually contaminating your liver. And these simple things will do magic stuff for you guys, for sure.
Yes, and you know, we have, I'll put later the ANF link, so everyone who's watching us can find a therapist near their place. There is a map on the website that you can find therapists, because ANF make a huge difference. And I had posted in other videos about the disconnection that our nerve system does, and once we have something that it's been chronic, all the connections and the talking between the nerves, the synapses, they get disturbed and they stop talking to each other. I always explain, like, one organ is starting to lend energy to the other, and then the other become weak, and then become the whole cycle of inflammation and pain and diseases coming along. So ANF is extremely efficient, and it's actually one of the only therapies I've seen working so fast and so quickly to reconnect and to redo all this rewiring, as I normally mentioned to it. So it's a great therapy, and I thank you so much. I thank your life every day for being helping so many women, and now we're talking about breasts, but so many people around the world. We're very, very grateful. Thank you.
I'm very grateful. I got the pleasure to have you as a patient, and then also to learn this. And now you're also teaching ANF worldwide. And it's a great honor for me. But also, when I met you the first time and felt your breasts and everything, and how we treated it, and it just vanished. Because cysts is active chronic invisible inflammation. That, as everything, when you get this kind of inflammation, is when it takes liquid and try to protect the cells and contract it, and most of all will go away when you get anti-inflammatory treatment. And here is ANF, the only thing in the world that can do that. Another thing that is important for you guys to understand, and our women that are watching this, is if you ever think that your breast doesn't have an important task after you stop breastfeeding and stuff, and we men probably think it's more like toys for us, forget it. It's a lifetime, extremely important part of your immune response. And this is very important that you take care of your breast and what you eat and how you drink water and stuff like this. We could live average much, much longer, especially you female, because you have unique things in your body. We can do another program about the female hormones and how they work that protect you that we men don't have. And here is your breast, a very big part of that program, because they need part of these chemical cells, or that you call hormone and that I call enzymes or acids and stuff like this, to actually keep your breast working good, because they're part of your lymphatic system. And that means it's part of your immune response. So if you do any kind of surgery to it, whatever you do to your breasts, it will definitely affect your immune system as well. Really more than you think. But because it takes 10 to 20 years until you see the results of it, so when it happens, we think Most people think it happened like yesterday or the last week, but the body's immune response is so strong. So everything you develop, you need to go back minimum 10 or 20 years to think of an emotional trauma that really affected your life. I used to say it can be a so simple thing that you were a little kid and you have your favorite teddy bear, and all of a sudden it was so dirty and it was broken and your mom or dad throw it away. But for you, that was the biggest emotional trauma at that time that you can ever think about. And then 20, 25 years later, you start to get cysts in your breast, you maybe get pain, you have constant period pain, which also actually is active inflammation, stuff like this. And you never will reflect on this teddy bear, but it's very, very important. So drink water, stay away from sugar, and do shopping instead of eating sugar when you feel bad. And yes, inform your husband more about this. Show him this video. Maybe he gets smarter. Because the good thing of being a man is we are the same all the time. And you guys are not. I used to say to all men that come here with a girlfriend that's having the first, waiting the first baby, I said, remember one thing, man, that is the woman you learn to know that you fall in love with, after you have this baby, will become another woman that you need to learn to know again. So from you being number two in her priority in life, you will be number 1,652. Because all her emotions and everything else is now something else. And the last thing I will say, just for you guys to understand the female emotional system, is that it's a reason a mother can feel if your daughter or son travels to the other side of the world, can feel that if something is wrong, you can feel it no matter where you are, because you're so connected that it's crazy. And the nerve system is so strong and the emotional system is so strong. And then we can take this as an aura or energy, whatever we want. But this is actually how it works. And all of these emotions for your women, you need to try to control it and work with it. Don't put it inside, get it out, because that's the only way you can protect yourself.
Yes, indeed. I have some questions here. Some people are asking, what is ANF? So just a quick brief of, you know, these discs. They're also asking what discs are using. I'm just going to quick explanation. I just had a baby, and as Dr. Mikkel was explaining about the inflammation, so I'm trying to balance my hormones. I have hypothalamus in one side and progesterone in the other side. I have vitamin C, and I have plenty for right now for my lymphatic system, as I stop breastfeeding now. So that is mine. I'm sure Dr. Mikkel has for other reasons. He's we have
liver, stomach, spleen, heart.
Yes.
Now, ANF is 25, 30 years ago when I started and also read medicine, is that everything you learn is talk about symptoms. Symptoms, pharmaceuticals, blah, blah, blah. We use a little time in school on the anatomy, the lymphatic system, the different organs and stuff like this. But when you come to diseases, it's no talk about the pre-process. So I started to focus on this and find out everywhere I went, people said, you're crazy. Why do you want to learn about the nerve system and all of this is stupid? You do so many years and study so hard and then you want to know about the pre-process? And it didn't take long time until I find out that the nerve system is actually the key to everything. As soon as your nerve system has a weak oscillation or inflammation, you will start to create what's called free radicals. And these free radicals or lipid peroxidation or whatever will start to damage your body. And because of our body's immune response is so strong, as long as we have healthy liver and healthy lymphatic system, it can fight anything. And that's why we can also live with diseases. But I find out that if we can have a device that can repair the oscillation in the nerve system and remove inflammation and strengthen the oscillation in the nerve system, we would never get sick, because that means the body will work optical all the time. So we started to measure different parts of the human body and find out the average frequencies of most of organs and systems. And from that, we 2012 or 2010, we find out to develop this disc. But this disc is not have anything to do with my invention. It's actually a NASA material. And it comes actually from an engineer that was helping them to develop it. It's carbonized metal. But what's unique with this is it can send, receive, and reflect frequencies. So you program the disc exactly as you charge a battery or how you're reading music to a CD in a very special machine where it lies, and you program it, and then like it lies and charge the carbonized metal, and then afterwards it's measured to make sure it's 100% perfect frequency. So today we have about 450 different discs. All of them have a very specific neurological frequency to work with heart, if it's heart between whatever we do. And the good thing about this, it's no chemicals, no organic substances. And people say to me that, how could this work? Because the knowledge about the nervous system is so limited. But you can imagine, we have what measurable 15 million different frequencies in the human body. We have billions and billions of different cells and neurons that constantly create fusion with each other and create the frequency. So everything we eat, everything we drink is actually to stimulate the nerve system's function and then also to create different cells. So when we talk about hormones, hormone is chemical cells, and these chemical cells that is produced in different areas in the body is actually to fuse with the nerve system's different neurons to create a function for that organ. And people say, but how is this work? And I said, have you ever thought about how NASA can send a satellite to Pluto or whatever, billions of kilometers away, and then it takes a picture and it comes back to Earth? Or how you can now look like on Instagram and we can see each other and we are different part of the world. It's because of frequencies. So this is why this is so unique. You can pre-program it. When the satellite is X billion kilometers away, the frequency from Earth is released, and then you take a picture, and then the same frequency make it come back to Earth, and then it's published in the news. So it's not big science. It's been known. I mean, scientists have tried for many, many decades to find a solution, what we now have done. And it's proving now to be more effective than I could ever imagine. I get shocked every day here in the clinic, and what all our therapists and doctors around the world is doing, it's crazy. But I'm so happy that we can help people with any kind of poison. And the good thing with this is you don't need to wait weeks or years for a result. We talk about minutes and days, and you notice it immediately. And Renata is a living proof. She can explain it herself.
Yes, and it's immediately, it's incredible. You know, it's literally as we apply, the result is immediately. You can already feel things changing. We have just a few more questions here to close it up. So there is Sabine asks, if you do recommend removal of benign small cysts?
No, I don't. Actually, I had all kind of cysts coming here, and even had people that come here with severe breast cancer, as you know. And what I have seen so far with this therapy is it actually, we didn't have anyone that didn't disappear. We had one woman that was here, I don't know if you were here, she had breast cancer, 8 by 8 centimeters, very serious tumor. And she done chemo, radiation, everything. And the purpose with chemo and all this is actually to make it shrink so they can make surgery. But they couldn't do it. And we treated her 2 weeks, and already in 30 minutes, it went from 8 centimeter to 1 centimeter. And she did a very good surgery after that. It was easy for the surgical to remove it. So if it's that bad stage, I mean, A&F is still worth it to make it shrink as good as possible. And instead of, she chose afterwards because of fear, of course, to remove both breasts. And for me, that is never a solution. It's just the beginning of another problem.
Exactly. As we said in A&F, we have to find the root cause. So why is this cysts being formed there? So you may remove now, and then what? In 6 months later, you're going to have another cyst, because what is it? Yes. That it's forming, as we explained, you know, the lymphatic system and so on and on. So, you know, it's hard to say, but we ideally, if you can have an A&F therapist, you know, or someone who look at you as a holistic approach and find out the root cause, not keeping removed cyst. As I told about my mom had cyst after cyst removed, and then it took to the point she had to remove all the glands.
No, but I mean, normal medicine, the reason I never want to work in the hospital is because I don't believe in it. I don't believe the solution is just to cut and stuff like that. Everybody that works in healthcare, we really want to help all that we can. But the system is not always allow it and doesn't give time to do it. And they don't have a tool like this today. I'm happy that it's going to be introduced next year in a lot of hospitals around the world with specific functions. But anyhow, I don't believe in cutting because I've seen everybody that do it, it will come other complications later. And again, what I told you before, it can take 10, 15, 20 years until it comes, but when it comes, it's even worse. I prefer to try everything else first, no matter what it is. I think it's very important and give that a chance before you do anything drastic. The solution is never to cut. Symptoms that you can be awareness of, that I think in this case is very important. Examine your groin and the lymphatic in the groin and see so it's no pain there. It's very important. It sounds weird. It's very far from the breast, I know. But you must remember, lymphatic system, cardiac system, and nerve system is three closed systems but work together as one. So I call them the three musketeers. If one of them doesn't work, you're gonna have a problem. In the groin, you should never ever have pain. And you can close to the pubic bone, dig in a little bit and see so there's no pain there. Another area that is very important, of course, is right over your nipples. And try to go deep in your breast and search for the lymphatic ending vessel there, because the lymphatic system is using the end of vessels to remove toxins and stuff. And there is one very, very important area.
I'll just show them. So it's basically the whole area underneath.
Yes.
So, yeah, you can palpate if you go on the shoulder line. Yeah, on the nipple line, and then just palpate around there so you can see how your lymphatic nodes are around the area.
And here, behind your jaw, is very important. If you check this constantly, at least once a month, so make sure it's never pain. You should feel pressure, but no pain. Then you're good. And if you drink water, stay away from sugar, you have absolutely done everything you can.
Good. Thank you very much. There is a lot of other questions that I'm going to try to do it privately, asking if it works for blood circulation, eczema in kids. Yes, it does. Literally works for everything. I had treated my daddy with kidney stones, and in like literally 10 minutes, the pain disappears. So it's literally, we can help with, you name it, as different kinds of pains and aches and diseases. And again, I'm very grateful for your life, for bringing quality of life and bringing health back once many of us like me was desperate in thinking was no more way of live without pain. And here I am with a baby breastfeeding and in completely optimal health. So I'll thank you very much. And I really, really would like to spread this to the world, because, you know, many people think living in pain and living like that, it's normal, it's getting old, and it's not. So we really need to listen to our body, take care of our body, and find ANF therapy near to you to help. So thank you for making time to be here with us.
Yes, it's my pleasure. As you said, everything we can share to the world and spread more knowledge, the more people will understand what's going on. And I hope we can come back, you and me, with another team that we can do, and maybe do this more often to help people to understand more about the human body.
That would be really great. I'll put on the agenda, and I'll be running after you for that.
I am here for all of you, so it would be my pleasure. It's probably easier than to spread things around the world if we do it like this. So thank you very much for inviting me, Renata, and give my love to your family and to all of you guys that's watching this now or later. Thank you for watching and thank you for listening, and take care of yourself and make sure to drink water.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye now. Bye.